100 dresses. The 100 dresses is divided into two parts, 100 dresses 1 and 100 dresses 2. In this we see the first part of 100 dresses. Let's see that. The writer population is A goes disturbed. How do we judge the people around us? By their money, wealth, or position? Or is there something or more at your value to look for in a person? Is there any value which is apart from the money, wealth, or position? The story is a sensitive account of how a poor young girl is judged by her classmates. Vanda Petrovich, the name of the girl is Vanda Petrovich. A young Polish girl who goes to school with other American children in an American town, who is coming from a very poor family, and who went to school with the other American children who are coming from the rich family. And that's why they made fun of the Vanda Petrovich. This other children see Vanda is different in many ways. Can you guess how they treat her? We can imagine that they are not treat her properly. They make fun of her. They are many chalk on her. Read the information in the video. The Polish American community in the United States. The first Polish immigrants arrived in America in 1968. It means the first Polish arrived in America in 1968. But the largest wave of Polish immigration occurred in the early 20th century. The immigration occurred in the 20th century. When more than 1 million Poles migrated to the United States, more than 1 million people migrated to the United States, it means in U.S. The Polish state did not exist at the time, and the immigrants were identified according to their country of origin rather than the origin. They were identified as Russian, German-born, and Australian-born. From three poles, they are migrated to Russia, Germany, and Australia. One of the most notable Polish American communities is in Chicago, and it's the worst. So Chicago is sometimes called the second largest Polish city in the world. Next, only to the Warsaw, the capital of Poland, Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated against the United States. As were the Irish, Italian, and Jews. The people of there are known as the Irish or Italian or Jews, which are country, from which country they come. According to the United States 2000 census, in which 667,414 Americans are aged 5 years, it means most of are the children. An older reported Polish as the language spoken at home, which is about 1.4% of the people who speak language other than English, or 0.25% of U.S. population who are speaking the other languages. Now, let's start the relation. Today, Monday, today is a Monday, and Vanda Petrovich was not in her city. She was not coming on that day. Normally Monday is the day when students are excited to go to school because they already rested on Sunday. But today is Monday and Vanda Petrovich is not coming at the school today. But nobody, not even Peggy and Vanda, the girls who started all the fun, notation of vaccines. Nobody notation that vaccine is not coming. Nobody you just know that vaccine is not coming soon. Usually they can say invitation to the last row of 13. She sit at the 13th number. She sat in the corner of the room where rough boys who did not make good marks. She sat at the last bench and in which the noted immunity students are sitting there. Mischievous students are sitting there. Where there was most topic of fit, mostly the students are scorching with the fit. Most roars of laughter on anything funny was said, and most word and dirt of the world. Vela did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. On the contrary, she was quiet and merry. She did not like to be serious. She liked to study, and that's why she did not like to sit there with them. She was very quiet and barely said anything to all, and nobody had ever heard her laugh aloud. She was very quiet girl. Nobody listened her to speak loudly or laugh loudly. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crooked sort of smile. But that was all. Nobody knew exactly why Rita sat in the seat. Unless it was because she came all the way from the Gobi Heights. And her feet were usually kept with the driver. There was a boy in the class whose name is Bogeshwar, who always approached the nails of mud, foot of mud with a floor, with a bench. But no one really thought much about Eventa Bekotsu. Once she sat in the corner of the room, nobody noticed that if she comes or not. Is she study or not? Even teachers did not take care of her. The time when we thought about Venta was outside of the school hours. In the class, nobody noticed that the Venta is present or not. But outside the class, when they want to make fun of someone, at that time they are searching for. At noon time when they were coming back to school, or in the early morning before beginning the school, when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the school yard. At that time, before the school began, after the school complete, they are finding the Venta because they want to make fun of. They sometimes they waited to Venta to have made fun. The next day, usually, Venta was not in the school either, and nobody noticed her absence again. But Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who are her partner, who are making most of the fun of Venta, who sat down in front with the other children, who got good marks and who did not break in a word, word of love. Lot of word. Did not notice that Mela wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. The most popular girl of the school is Peggy. She was pretty. She had many pretty clothes and her hair was curly. Maddie was her closest friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Venta's actions was because Venta had made them late in school. They had waited and waited for Venta to have some fun with her and then just hadn't come. They waited for Venta because if she come, they make fun of her, but she didn't come. They often visited Venta Bekotsu to help without one minute. Venda had not said, most of the children in the room hurting didn't have name back. They have name Easy Kushi. Actually, Venda's name is also a funny. And that's why they take one of other children's name are easy in comparison to speak of Venda. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Sheet, or Eric. There was one boy named Burns, Willie Burns, and people thought that was funny, but not funny on the same of Petrovski was. One name in the class was funny, and the name funny was the Willie Burns, but in the comparison of Petrovski, people thought that it is not as funny as Petrovski. When I did not have any friends, she came to school alone and went home alone one day. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. It was clean, but looked as if it never been ironed properly. It was clean, there was no dirt on the cloth, but it looked like that it didn't iron any kind. Sometimes they surrounded her in the school yard. Instead of watching the girls play hopscotch, it means a game. Children hop into over square and mark the ground. One more on the ground, Venda, Peggy would stay in the most convincing manner as though she were talking to Miss Maggie. It's a very convincing manner she talked like talk with her. Venda, she would say, giving one of her friend Kanak Kalas, how many dresses did you share? You had hanging up on the clothes. I said that. The baby asked Venda that, how many dresses you have in your cupboard? 100. Venda would say, 100? Except all the girls, because they wore every time you do a dress. And she said that at that time she said that she has 100 dresses. Incredibly, and the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and wishing. Yeah, 100 whole line, said Venda. Then her king lips grew together in silence. It means the lips are silence. What are they like? Old, said, I bet, said Venda. At that time, they asked, they raised another question, which kind of dresses you have? Yeah, all same, all colors. At that time, Venda answered that I have all the same dresses in all the colors. Velvet to velvet. Yeah, velvet to white, velvet to real also. 100 dresses, Venda would repeat slowly. All kind of in my closet, it means in my almari, in my cupboard. Then they let her go. And then before she would go very far, they wouldn't try brushing into strings and tears of love. At that time, they are not love. But after her went, when she went out from that, they are brushing of love. Then how can a girl have 100 dresses of all the materials? Because the girl will raise the blue headed dress. 100 dresses, obvious. The only dresses Venda had were blue, were worn every day. So why did she have 100? What a story. How many schools did you say you have? At that time, she answered, I had 60 pairs of schools. 100 dresses and 60 pairs. All lined up in my closet, cries of expressive politeness greeted this. All alike? Oh no, every pair is different. All colors, all line. Hey, who had thought of this day? And Mary, her inseparable friend, who would face or do as the baby said. Where always the last two leaves? up to sleep. Her eyes dull and her mouth closed. Hitching her lamp spider every now and then in the funny way she had, finishing to talk to school alone. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies. Peggy was not a cruel person. She always tried to save her from the bullies. Bullies is a name, bullies is a word. Those who are making strange power fighting of the weaker people. And she cried for others if so and anyone mistreated. If anyone had said to her, "Don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Venda?" She would have been really surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that she was lying. Why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person. Else, why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. As for Maddie, this business of asking Venda every day how many dresses and how many hats and how many this and that they are asking and going to Venda, Maddie was poor herself. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes, it means the second clothes that somebody gave to her. Thank goodness, she didn't live up on the bogus height for him, the funny man. At that time, she thanked God that I haven't the dresses that the people can follow me. Sometimes when Peggy was asking, Venda was patient in her mockingly polite voice. Mary fell, embraced, and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing. Herself. Not that she felt sorry for Venda. Exactly, she would never have paid any attention to Venda. If Peggy hadn't invited the dresses then, but suppose Peggy and all the others started in her own midst, she wasn't as poor as Venda. Perhaps, but she was poor. Of course, she would have more sense than say, she had 100 dresses. Still, she could not lie for that to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Venda about it. That time, Peggy was hoping that as soon as possible, Peggy would stop to tease her. What will happen with Venda approaching? We will see into our next video. Have a nice day.